Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Causal Impact package created by Google estimates the impact of an intervention on a time series. For example, how does a new feature on an application affect the user's time on the app? In this tutorial, we will talk about how to use the Python package Causal Impact to do time series causal inference. You will learn how to set the pre and post periods for the causal impact analysis, how to conduct causal inference on time series data, how to summarize the causality analysis results and create a report. What are the differences between the Python and the R packages for causal impact? Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import libraries. Firstly, let's install CausalImpact for time series causal analysis. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. Pandas, NumPy, and DataTime are imported for data processing. ArmaProcess is imported for synthetic time series data creation. Matplotlib and Seaborn are for visualization. CausalImpact is for time series treatment effects estimation. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic time series dataset for the causal impact analysis. The benefit of using a synthetic dataset is that we can validate the accuracy of the model results. The causal impact package requires two types of time series: a response time series that is directly affected by the intervention, and one or more control time series that are not impacted by the intervention. The idea is to build a time series model to predict the counterfactual outcome. In other words, the model will use the control time series to predict what the response time series outcome would have been if there was no intervention. In this example, we created one response time series variable and one control time series variable. To make the dataset reproducible, a random seed is set at the beginning of the code. Then an autoregressive moving average process is created. The autoregressive part has two coefficients 0.95 and 0.05, and the moving average part has two coefficients 0.6 and 0.3. After creating the autoregressive moving average process, 500 samples are generated from the process. The control time series variable x is created by adding a constant value of 10 to the generated values. The response time series variable y is a function of the control time series variable x. It equals 2 times x plus a random value. The intervention happens at the index of 300, and the true causal impact is 10. A time series usually has a time variable indicating the frequency of the data collected. We created 500 dates beginning on January 1, 2021 using the pandas date range function, indicating the dataset has daily data. After that, a pandas data frame is created with the control variable x, the response variable y, and the dates as index. In step 3, we will set the pre and the post intervention periods. Using df index, we can see that the time series start date is 2021-0101, the time series end date is 2022-0515, and the treatment start date is 2021-1028. Next, let's visualize the time series data. In the chart, the blue line is the control time series, the orange line is the response time series, and the red vertical line represents the intervention start date. We can see that before the intervention, the control and response time series have similar values. After the intervention, the response time series consistently has higher values than the control time series. The Python causal impact package requires the pre and the post periods inputs in a list format. The first element in the list is the starting index, and the last element in the list is the ending index. The intervention start date is 2021-1028, so the pre-period ends at 2021-1027. In step 4, we will calculate the raw difference between the pre and the post periods. We can see that the pre-treatment daily average is -1.64, the post-treatment daily average is 50.08, and the raw difference between the pre and the post-treatment is 51.7, which is much higher than the true causal impact of 10. Without causality analysis, we will overestimate the causal impact. In step 5, we will execute the causal impact analysis on the time series. The causality analysis has two assumptions. Assumption 1, there are one or more control time series that are highly correlated with the response variable, but not impacted by the intervention. Violation of this assumption can result in wrong conclusions about the existence, the direction, or the magnitude of the treatment effect. Assumption 2, the correlation between the control and the response time series is the same for pre and post intervention. The synthetic time series data we created satisfy the two assumptions. The Python causal impact package has a function called CausalImpact that implements a Bayesian structural time series model on the backend. It has three required inputs. Data takes the Python data frame name. Pre-period takes the starting and the ending index values for the pre-intervention period. Post-period takes the starting and the ending index values for the post-intervention period. After saving the output object in a variable called impact, we can run impact.plot to visualize the results. The visualization consists of three charts. The first chart plots the predicted counterfactual values and the actual values for the post period. The second chart plots the point effects, which are the differences between the actual and predicted values. We can see that the pre-period point effects values are all around 0, and the post-period point effects values are all around the true impact of 10. The third chart plots the cumulative effect, which is the cumulative sum of the point effects from the second chart. In step 6, we will summarize the causal impact of the intervention for the time series. The summary from impact. Summary tells us that the actual post-intervention average is 50.08, and the predicted post-intervention average is 40.3. The absolute causal effect is 10.06, which is very close to the true impact of 10, and much better than the raw difference of 51.7. The relative causal effect is 25.12%. The posterior probability of a causal effect is 100%, showing that the model is very confident that the causal impact exists. We can print the report version of the summary using the output equals report option. In step 7, we will talk about the Google Causal Impact package differences between Python and R. The Python package was ported from the R package, so most of the time the two packages produce similar results, but sometimes they produce different results. The differences are caused by assumptions for prior initializations, the optimization process, and the implementation algorithms. The CausalImpact package documentation highly recommends setting the prior level SD to none, which will let stats model do the optimization for the prior on the local level component. Based on this suggestion, a version with the option prior level SD equals none is created. We can see that the point estimation values are similar, but the standard deviations are smaller for the estimation. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about causal inference, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.